Hi all, now we are going to look about CAM analyzer experiment. We have studied about the CAM flow away mechanism in kinematics and machinery. So now this is a simple experimental setup for CAM flow away. Now we can see this is a symmetrical CAM. So this half will be exactly looking same as this half. Also we know about rise return dwell period. So now here in this CAM, so by looking itself we can able to identify that 180 degree is the dwell period. So this is perfectly circular, 180 degree is perfectly circular, and 90 degree is the rise period and 90 degree is the return period. So this is the total profile of the CAM. So now in this experiment what we are going to do is from this experimentally we can measure the CAM rise and draw the profile of the CAM. So now we can see this is following with the roller follower. So this is a roller follower. So CAM is touched with the roller follower. Okay. So now, so you know that, so on the dwell period there will be no lift. So now what we are going to do is this is the dial gauge. So this is connected with the dial gauge over here. And initially we have to set the dial gauge to zero. So initially we have to set the dial gauge to zero. Okay. So anyhow, because of some tolerance build up on this assembly, there may be some deviation. So now we can keep this roller perfectly aligned axis along this profile. So now we are going to keep the, since this should be having a zero deflection, we have to keep exactly perpendicular like this. We have to keep this CAM like this. So if I rotate in this direction, it should be a dwell. If I rotate in this direction, it start rise. Whenever I rotate this CAM in this direction, so this will go up, this will go up, there will be rise on this. Okay. So so again we have to keep it at zero. Because of some error build up on that, slightly it may vary. Now this is exactly zero position. This is exactly zero position. Now we have to mark over here. We have to mark over here. This is around 352 degree. So we are not bothered about this degree. Now what we are going to do is, now we are going to raise this for 10 degree. So if I rotate this here, this will raise for 10 degree. So if I rotate here, from here if I keep it to some 2 degree like this. Now I rotate 10 degree. So for 10 degree of rotation, how much is the raise here? That we have to know. So we have to mark degree, 10 degree. And this rise we have to mark. So this may be from 0, it deflects only 2 mm. So the least count is 0.02, so 0.025 mm only rise. So there is no big difference in the rise. Again I have to rotate this for 10 degree. So for each and every 10 degree rise, I have to measure the dial gauge deflection. So from 60 degree only it will be showing higher deflection. Up to 60 degree there will not be big deflection. So again I rotate this for 10 degree. So now I have to measure the deflection as 0.1. Again I have to rotate, now this becomes 20 degree. From here I rotate 20 degree totally. Now I have to go with the another 10 degree. So this becomes 30 degree and the deflection becomes 0.28 mm. So like that again 40 degrees deflection. So I rotate for 40 degree. Now it becomes 0.62 mm rise. 50 degree deflection. So it rises further. Similarly up to 90 degree I have to measure. So one rotation becomes 1 mm. So up to 90 degree I have to measure. Similarly every steps of 10 degree I have to measure. So so for total 10 degree how much rise it comes. So total rise, that is the total lift that we have to measure. So since this is symmetrical, while returning the dial should come back. So like this. While returning, yes, every 10 degree deflection we have to make it back and ensure that it is coming back again to 0 degree. Ensure that it is coming again back to 0 degree after return. So since practically due to some error building on that, we cannot exactly get the 0 degree again. What we can do is, whatever the reading we have measured on the rise, that the same proportion we can subtract and get the value on the return. So based on the rise value and the displacement value, we can plot a graph for CAM profile. So for plotting the graph, we need the base circle diameter of the CAM as well as roller diameter of the CAM. So using vernier, we have to measure the base circle diameter of the CAM and roller diameter of the CAM.
we have to measure the base circle diameters, it will be coming around 40 mm, and we have to measure this roller radius, roller diameter also. This comes around 26 mm. So now, like how we have plotted the cam theoretically, in the same manner we have to plot the graph with base circle diameter and prime circle. With the roller radius, we have to draw the prime circle, and for each and every 10 degree raise, we have to raise the displacement and mark the cam profile. Thank you.